So, hi, it's Minecraft Grand, the Geeky Minecrafter, and I'm bringing you another episode of Minecraft. I hope you'll forgive the rough start. It's been an interesting week. I am going to going to try and bring you on some pretty good Minecraft. I thought what we'd do today is we'd spend a little time on the Archimonde server. If you'll remember from our farewell tour last week, Sun did reset the server. It is now pure vanilla, which means we've all pretty much started over. She did update to 1.9.4, and as you can see, Minecraft Addict is still at 1.9 and Cherry Vanilla is at 1.9.2. So if I switch between servers now, I actually have to switch between profiles. And for those of you who are unfamiliar with that, let me show you what that looks like. There we go. So when you launch Minecraft, if you're using the launcher, you come in with this profile here on the left-hand side. And hopefully I've been able to zoom in and show you that. I do have multiple profiles, and I don't have one for 1.9.2, so let me go ahead and set that up. Basically, I'm going to be on my 1.9.4 profile, and I'm going to click New. Whichever one you're on, when you click New, it'll make a copy of that one. So if I wanted to start with this one that is a much older version, I'd click here and then click New Profile. Now I like 1.9.4, I've already got it kind of dialed in. So I'll click New and it'll make a copy of it. And I'll get rid of that, Minecraft Grand. And we're gonna call this 1.9.2 because this is where, I have it on my, Is that right? Sorry, there we go. I have the hotkeys set up on my numeric keypad. I apologize. So 1.9.2 goes there. We're going to change this release to be 1.9.2. I'm going to leave my arguments the same and save the profile. Now, I can choose between 1.9, 1.92, and 1.94. For Archimonde is 1.94, so I'll go ahead and start there. Come on. Here we go. There we go, multiplayer. Let's refresh. Scanning. Pinging. Come on, really? You know, I was just in here playing not 10 minutes ago. New machine, new settings, a bunch of new stuff. I am struggling a little bit. Let's see if that works. I apologize. Okay. So, oh my goodness. What is going on? What is this? Is there somebody in my house? What is this? PBT, is this you? I have a haunted boat in my house. Okay, as you can tell, my chicken cooker is working overtime. Okay, so it looks like I'm back to streaming. We'll start the tour over. Okay, I apologize if you were trying to follow what was going on. So just to recap real quickly, Sun reset the server. It's now all pure vanilla. We established spawn, built a building, and then ran about, I want to say, 1,000 blocks in one direction and 1,000 blocks on the Z direction as well, and found this little really cool floating mountains. It kind of reminded me of, you know, the movie Avatar with these floating islands and stuff like this. So I found this, and Rims was right behind me. So we established a small little colony here, and it wasn't long before PBT and Sun Goddess decided to join us. So we are establishing kind of a community area right here. So I live in this mountain, and there will be stuff up above. Sun Goddess lives in this mountain, or up on top of this one. Ramses lives, let me find it. I have to jump right up here. Jump over the water. Okay. You see those trees right there? He lives right on the other side of those trees. There's a bit of a mountain there. and then this mountain here. Now this stairway goes up and around and over and up and over and over and over and over, and that's where Sun Goddess lives. So we do have a desert right here behind us, which is really awesome. And I understand from notes that PBT placed in line, they found a mesa. I haven't seen it with my own eyeballs, so I don't know where it is yet. But that's going to be coming soon. So, many of you know I like to jump in a hobbit hole and establish myself before I start running around out there where the scary people are. Because, you know, you can die out there, and that's really easy in 1.9. So one thing I did was, ran downstairs, built a mine, and mined out a bunch of resources, built a fish farm, so when I'm AFK, I'm, gathering those, and then began enchanting. So I'm not 100% where I want to be, but I feel like I can walk outside without being killed by the nearest thing that, will eat you. You gotta love monsters for that. Okay, so let me throw some of this offline. Organics, and then I'll give you the rest of the tour. So I think I can show you before it gets dark. Let me see how long we have until it's dark. It's not too bad. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to head for spawn and show you what's going on there. Again, we're just starting, so a lot of the resources, a lot of the infrastructure isn't really here. And because it is pure vanilla, there's some of this that's just not going to exist. Now there are a couple of community farms, and look, let's see where I have a little pop out right up here. I think you can see it from down here. I knocked a hole out. Let's see, can you see it? Let me find it. Yeah, right there. So I've traveled through. I know that it goes all the way through. I've punched a hole out this side and that side so that I kind of have my boundaries. There's Sun's house up there, and it's just, this walkway winds around this mountain, and she's just being really creative. So Rems and I, on the way back, guided by GPS, if you will, we laid these torches down so we'd be able to find ourselves. I think there's two paths, and I think this is the one that heads over to the village that we found. And then from the village, it also leads to spawn. So we're running. Looks like I see a couple of bad guys out there. Maybe they don't see me. Maybe if I run fast enough, they won't know I'm here. Because God knows we're not being stealth, right? Oh, please get there before dark. So is it just me, or are the bunnies in 1.9 smaller? They all seem like babies to me. We do have a few new people on this server. Welcome to Aquamouse. I think it's going to be fun playing together here on the server. Let's see. The water well means we're close. And am I giving this away? Ramsey, are you going to be mad at me for showing people where the village is? Because we wanted to kind of keep this to ourselves. But it's so near spawn. Good night, PBT. Let's see. Yeah, we're almost dark here, so I will have to spend a little bit of time at spawn. There's not that much to give you a tour, so I don't know what we'll do. Maybe we'll just chat, or maybe we'll jump on a different server. I really haven't given you a tour of my place, but you know my place. I mean, if you watch any of my videos at all, you know what I do. I have a fish farm. I have a chicken farm. Oh, goodness. Oh, my goodness. Parkour over the over the caverns here. I think we're close. I think it's right over this hill. I hope it's close. Let's see. Right through here. Oh, yeah, we're getting close. I recognize the landscape. There's the portal. Here we go. We do have a beacon. Oh, look, somebody put a clock tower on top. Aren't they creative? See, that's just never. Looks like somebody's marking maybe the spawn chunk. I'm not real sure. Or the beacon effects. What do you think? So that leads to the nether, obviously. I don't know that we have a hub set up yet. This is the beautiful area where people spawn. So I believe what Sun did was she set somewhere right in here as the initial spawn point. So if you join the server, you get accepted, you spawn in the first time, you're going to land right here. This does introduce you to the staff. Some of the people that you'll be seeing here, some of the people that are helping. Look, there's my name. Because I'm trying to give Sun some help. So if you guys have problems, you know, and I'm online, let me know. Now, because it is pure vanilla, that means, you know, people, there's no core protect, there's no locks, there's none of that. So we do take griefing and stealing and, you know, disrespect. We take that stuff serious. If you break a rule, you'll be temporarily banned. If you continue to break the rules when you come back, you'll be permanently banned. We just have no tolerance for people who want to come online and be jerks. Okay, so don't be that person. So I am watching chat. If you have any questions, feel free to, you know, drop them in there. Again, when you spawn in, there is a little bit of a community area right here. Potatoes, carrots, beetroots, and wheat. So harvest what you need, replant, and that should help you get started. So pretty cool. Let me see if I can back out. I'll tell you what, I might have to go outside the gate, aren't I? Get over here where I can see this little clock tower. Look at this, it's 3 a.m. Must be 3 a.m. because it's dark outside. That is so cool. I don't know who did that, but you are so creative. Okay, so that's it in the way of a tour. We can pop through the nether portal. I don't think there's much out there. I mean, unless they've been busy while I was gone. I have been in the mine for quite a few days. Really? Gravel for days. And then soul sand. So, is this man-made? Do you think somebody put this down here? I don't know. I'm thinking this is a good place to come to get gravel. We all know I like gravel for my lava pits. Oh, look at this. You know what? I have silk touch. Everybody's happy. Do I have any blocks to get up there? I do. It's stone because I've been using my silk touch to go mining. Miner Bob. Oh, nope. Yeah, it's Miner Bob. Just take a little of this with us before we leave. Hope you don't mind. I've been meaning another trip out here now that I've got the silk touch. Did you hear anybody? Huh. I don't know. He must be right below us. You don't think he's mad, do you? My armor's not that good. If he's mad, I'm dead. I can just stay up here till he goes away. How long will it take? Too long. There we go. Alright, I think that's what I was looking for. Uh-oh. There we go. Big, big ball of... Grab this. Uh, Okay, so take this out and head down. Go get my stuff. Oh, come on. Really? We all know how I do on parkour. Oh, that was close. For a little guy, he is making a lot of noise. You see that, right? It scares me when they go running at me. I don't know if you watched the video. I was making a gold farm, and oh my god. So I'm working with them. You know, they're okay. I'm running around. I'm in the gold farm with them. No big deal, right? And I had left a hole into the farm, and I had left and jumped over the water and gone out and was doing a couple things. So I was in the area where you're meant to stand, the AFK station, and ooh, that was close. Still had an Still had a place open. Oh, you know what? Where is out? Do you know where out is? I don't know where out is. I don't want to get greedy or anything, but yeah. Anyway, so I'm standing down there where you're meant to stand, and dang it if, you know, I'm thinking, we've got time. I can kill this one guy that's, you know, that I see wandering around. The little guy, he'd gotten out. I can kill him because, guess what? You know, they're all locked in there, right? Well, no, as it turns out, I had forgotten about that hole I had opened up, and so when I killed the little guy, a whole bunch of them tracked me and jumped in that hole and were all over me before I could turn around, and I died. And then, so I jumped back in game, right? Because I had slept there in that room. Jumped back in, and they're still in there. And they're still wailing on me. And now I've got nothing. I've got no armor, so, I mean, one hit and I'm dead, right? So I jumped back in, I mean, I'm dying, like, repeatedly. And I'm doing all this on camera. Just by the way, I'm screaming, it's crazy, there were tears, I'm just saying. So yeah, I have a little bit of a concern about the zombie pigmen, because they are, man, they hit hard. I just need a little of this right here. Okay. Alright, so now it's time to try and find my way out. Did I get major lost? I think I came in over here. Do you remember? Just want the portal. Oh, that's not good. Oh, I know better than to do this. I did not come by this, but I think, let's see, was it over here? Yes. Oh my goodness. Okay, I see the stairway. Right? Yeah. Oof. That was close! So I wonder who's going to be pissed off if I take this gravel with me. I better wait and ask, since it does look man-made. Okay. Back to spawn. And yay, it's daylight. So, running back to the base. Now, if you won't tell anybody, I am an admin, so I can TP. Shh, don't tell anybody. Where are my coordinates? 72. Oh, phew. Thought I fell. I'm in here alone, aren't I? Yep. So the only thing is the video graphic evidence. So let's see. I guess I could take you up and show you Sun's place up there before it gets dark again. And see, I'm wandering around with all this good stuff in my inventory. I want to kind of put a path out here. So I think... There we go, back up. Now, it's strange to me that she chose to start way over here on this side to put this up here. I mean, she obviously had her reasons, right? But, oh, gotta be careful here, because, you know, one misstep and you're history, Bretta. Let's go up, let's go up. Over, across, around, I mean... She's got great views, but wow. I almost fell off. That would be so bad. So it looks like she's missing a couple of steps there and there. I guess having to jump one is not so bad, right? Okay, so leave it to Sun to go high and tight with her spruce wood. With great views all the way around. I mean, really. She's so high, she's up here in the clouds. For the love of Pete. Let's see if we can get oriented. The desert. There's one of the floating isles. That means I'm this way, right? No. Oh, I'm that. That little guy right there. So, that's the top of my hill. If you look right down here, you should... I don't know if you're going to be able to see it, but... Yeah, my intention is to have a balcony off of there, to have a garden up top. I will be building up, much as Sun did, but not quite as beautifully as she's done. So that's it. I'm ready to go get busy building. Wonder who has a portal over there. Who do you think is that? I don't know. Okay, you know what I should do? Come down out of the clouds a little bit. Take one wrong step here and you're toast. Oh, there's a horse over there. So, I am the resident saddle maker. Because of my fish farm, I have a lot. I mean, a lot of saddles. I have... 3 double chests worth so far, and you know, by the time I do an AFK session tonight, that may be 4. That AFK on the fish farm yields a lot of enchanted books, which is the reason I do it, and it yields other benefits as well. Let me shorten my path here a little bit. Hey. You know, this is where I was last time. I bet he's underground. I bet he is. What do you think? I'm not gonna go looking for him right now. Oh. Goodness. So I haven't decided quite what to do here. I came over here, I dropped a little bit of food off, I dug into the wall, and like I said, I built what I needed in here, and did not come out until I was had it all done. So I had armor, a little bit of a few chests worth of stuff, a fish farm. Let's run down here. A little bit more storage, and as you can see, I wasn't lying about the saddles, right? That's just crazy. And I have quite a bit of fish too. You need fish? I think I've got some overflow up there. Look at this. I puffer fish for days. There's my incinerator. My chicken farm. So I have plans down here. Was planning to put my nether portal on one side. No, actually my nether portal on this side. And a sorting room on this side. And you know from Cherry Vanilla that I like to do the big sorters. And then up here... Let's just show you plans, okay? This is going to... I don't know. I don't know over here yet. This upstairs is going to be my bedroom level. And remember I told you I'd poked holes out? So I've just explored to see, you know, where everything is. So I have quite a bit of space up here. Look at this. So what is that? About 20 blocks that way and about 30 blocks that way. And I'm just going to hollow this mountain out. Put glass all the way around. Do all kinds of fun stuff up in here. I do want to do a couple of, you know, automated food farms. I do want to do an exit down here that, you know, just kind of leaves here, drops down at an angle, and leads over to my, you know what? We didn't see the village. Huh. Oh, well. Another time, then. I think I made a left when I should have made a right or something like that, but anyway, I want to leave a trail down to the village so that when I, you know, want to run down there and do some trades and whatnot, I can just head out that door, make it short. So bedroom level, work level, I don't know what we're going to do here. I think maybe a big balcony, like an outdoor area, fire pit, garden, seating area. I don't know. I like being outside in real life. In Minecraft, it's a little bit scary because the days are so short, but I do like being outside. And I think right up here, let me turn around and look. I think a balcony right here would be kind of sweet. I don't know what we're going to do over here. I'm hoping maybe a mob farm. But we'll see. Okay. So let me get in here and get safe. I think... Oh, one last thing. So one of the things Ramses and I did, you saw how close he lives to me, right? So we grabbed some coordinates, we ran down here, and we tunneled towards each other and met in the middle. And that has become the primary shaft of the mine. So this runs... You know, on the, what is it, east and west? Yeah, east and west axis, right? And I do mine at 6. He does his at 11. So this is the 11th level up here, or, you know, block 11. Let's go this way. I do have some lava I'm dealing with over here. There are a couple of caverns over here and down through there. But this leads... straight over underground to Ramsey's place, which is awesome. It allows us to come down and mine together without ever hitting the surface. Now, I'm working on convincing him to fill in his voids. He does like to do that. And to block off, you know, when he cuts a channel like this, to block it off so that no mobs can wander back down here. In fact, should I show you this? I'm going to show you this. He built a spider farm. Actually, Ramses, I found a shorter way. So this is the one you go in, and then you do all that hop, skipping, and jumping around. If you go this way, it's almost a direct shot. It's right through here, unless you blocked it off. It looks like you have been filling in your voids. It'll be just my luck. The one time I don't want you to fill in a void, you have filled it in. It's not there. It is, I think, right here. Oh, come on. Really? You did. You filled it in. Okay, I'll go this way. Now, I did put down markers, thankfully, because I'd have never found it again if he hadn't. So it's up, it's around. Now, he built a complicated spider farm. I'm still working on the mechanics, getting it right. Let's see, I think it goes down. Yep, down, down, down. Yep, here we go. Oh, goodness. Hey, he had his back to me. How could he shoot me with his back to me? Come on. Does that seem fair to you? Doesn't seem fair to me. Okay. So, this is the area. I'm just checking for bad guys. So, up here is where you can watch the spawner. And then down here is where you play in the spawner. Uh-oh. Oh, here we go. Oh, interesting. Okay, so if I remember right, you have to open this. That opens the gate so the spiders can get here. I think you close the water, let them build up. Right? So after they've built up for a little while, you, let's see, close the gate so no new ones can get in, turn the water on, press the button. Because it's mending. And then they should be one hits. It's pretty complicated. Like I said, here, let's open this again so they can get through. They're stacking up on me. So it's a complicated farm, but it works. I mean, it's a quick way to run your XP up, or repair your mending tools in my case. Breaks farm, press button when water's on. Okay. So yeah, he did a good job. I don't know that I fully understand it. Here, let's turn this off. Turn this on. There's only one in there, but you get the idea. Didn't I turn the water on? No, I turned it off. Good grief. See what I mean? You got it, switches and buttons and yeah. Okay. So that's it. You know what? Let's go to Cherry. I'm working on a mob farm there, and I'm anxious to spend some time on that. Okay. So how are we gonna do this? I'm gonna cheat. I'm gonna jump back the easy way so that I'm in a safe place. Oh, it scared me. Do you see it jump? Do you see me jump? Okay, we're gonna disconnect from here. Need to exit out and come back in under the different profile. So I think what we'll do is we'll call this episode. I'll just bid you adieu, and I'll start the next recording. This one will be on the Cherry server, so stay tuned for that episode. In fact, look for the link down below. You should see a link for that. If you're interested in playing on the Archimonde server, check us out. There should also be a link down below for that as well. I look forward to playing with you on Minecraft. Come on, let's play Minecraft together. This is Minecraft Gran, the Geeky Minecrafter, signing out. Happy mining!